Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of creation process. And in this video we'll be creating this logo. So to create this logo, we will first use an ellipse tool. So select the ellipse tool, make a circle. Now we need to adjust the dimensions, so we will use the ruler tool. The shortcut for ruler tool is Ctrl R, which will hide and unhide the ruler option. So just with the mouse click, drag out the lines and just adjust their corners, all the four sides. The reason why we are using the ruler tool is to maintain their dimension and to be accurate while placing or while doing any further stuff. So just maintain the dimensions, see that they are coinciding here, all the four sides. Once you got that, we will just begin with our tutorial. We will need a rectangle, and I'll just draw a rectangle here and give it some color, and just select both the object, go to Pathfinder. Here we go, we got a Pathfinder palette. Just combine it. Once you combine that, we'll just duplicate this by clicking Ctrl C, and to paste it, Ctrl F, which will paste the object in the front and scale it down. Once you scale it down, let's do one thing. I just select both the object, remove their colors, and give the outline some colors so you can see the outlines. Now with the selection tool, select the corners here and just drag it out by using the arrow keys. Now select both the object with the selection tool and subtract it in the Pathfinder. You got this object. Now we will further go to the further stuff where we will be doing some details here. And I have already created some color palettes which I would be needing while doing this color stuff. So here I have selected few colors, color shades, which I'll be using while coloring this logo. So it's where sometimes you need to decide which color you have to choose before for your logo. So you have to create the color palette and then create the logo and apply that color in it. So here let's apply it. So we will just create this logo before that. So I take an ellipse tool and make a circle here. One. Now I need what we need is we will divide this object into two parts. So I take the circle and put this corner here, just maintaining that it's parallel to it over the point, over the line, and just scale it up by clicking shift, which will drag scale this gradually. Once you get that, again place that, place this corner around here, and scale it up a little bit more. Just make sure that it's intersecting here. Now once you get that, we will select both the object and go to Pathfinder and divide it. So it will divide every part separately, which we will ungroup it all and delete the part which we don't need. So I don't need this. We don't need this smaller portion above here, so I'll just delete this. So we got this and this. Here we got two objects. We will just select both the object and combine it. So you got one object, two object. So further go to the next step. I'll take a circle and give some cuts here. So I'll just make this bigger one and keep it much more bigger, and I'm just dividing this half. So I'll just keep this like this. Okay, and I'll duplicate one more time, duplicate it, and just keep it. See that this these two points are intersecting here, and little bit, if you need it, just make it more bigger or more less smaller, and play with it, zoom in and work with it. I'm just playing with the strokes right now because right now I want to concentrate on the curves which is forming. So now I select all the object and divide it. Now ungroup it all, selecting by selecting it, ungroup it all, delete the stuff which you don't need, like this, you need this, you don't need this one, delete this part, delete this part, all the extra parts which is useless you delete it. And we got, now we got almost this part, this part, almost every part is separated. So next we will go on further more detailing stuff. So just we will make one more circle here and we will keep it here. Okay, once you get that, I'll duplicate this one more time by clicking Alt and dragging it out. I'll duplicate it one more time, clicking it and dragging it out. So in this way, I think I have completed my ring stuff. So I select all of them and do the same thing, divide it and delete, ungroup it all and delete the parts which I don't need in my designs. So delete it all, delete it all, delete it all. So this is the main part which we will be working on. So you can delete the guides like selecting it and deleting it using the keyboard. And here we go with the colors. And here we have two more stuff which we need to be deleted. We don't need this and this, only the C part. First I'll go with the shade. Here I will fill it with light color of yellow, then this one little bit of darker yellow, this one orange, and I'll fill this one with dark green and this one with light green. In the way I'll fill this with light green, this one with this one. Select it properly because there are lots of divisions here, so you have to select it carefully and color fill the color exactly the same. This one dark green. I'll fill this three part with purple, this three part with purple. So here we go with the purple, this one with dark blue, which I'm having right now only one blue, so I'll edit it later, and this one with the same blue. Here I will fill it with blue, just see the color combination and just fill it out. This one with yellow and this one with dark green, and let's fill this with dark green and this one with, I think, orange, maybe lighter orange. So just see which color matches the you can use this and you can fill this with maybe orange or maybe green was, I think, good because almost everywhere there is orange. So let's play with the gradient here, or maybe color depth. So I'll apply some gradient here just using the purple color. So fill this with purple and apply some gradient. So here we got a black, join the purple here, choose one purple color and this one too purple color. So purple, it's really dark, so choose this one, go to the palette and play with the purple's color, lighter to darker. So once you get that, we will just select this one with the gradient tool, drag it out. So here we got, we will just rewrite up a little bit more, just like this, and you got a lighter tone of purple color and a dark purple color at this same opposite side. Just so it will give some depth. The same way they choose this one, apply the gradient and play with the gradient. Choose this one and apply the same. Give this little bit of plain color because it's like dark. We need some depth here, so this is creating some change in difference and creating a depth feel. In the same way, I'll apply some gradient here too. Or maybe if you don't want it, you can, it's your wish. I feel I should do it for the tutorial. So here we need green, so let's take some green color here. Let's this one and the another one also green, and we will just take one of the green color and darken that color. So here we got it. I'll just darken this a little bit more, and we got the gradient. So choose it, apply it, choose it, apply it. So here we got it. We'll select this one and apply the same with the picker tool. You can select the gradient color and just apply it. This will create some 3D feel. Now we will change this into some gradient color. So I have chosen this one. We will open the gradient color here. Give it some, give this also some, and play with the gradient. Here too, you got blue one, select it and apply the gradient. We will do some for orange also. So we select this one, apply some orange color. So it's like you're using gradient to make it more depth, make it more catchy. And okay, so let's darken this orange color and this one, brighten this up. It's very I think very bright little orange, so let's lose it. So with the gradient, choosing a gradient tool, we will some play with this gradient stuff to get that. We will select this green and choose the gradient color, or maybe this, and play the gradient. You have left this one, we will select this. And with the gradient color, just play with it. We will select this and apply the gradient color. And with the gradient tool, we will apply it. So here we got some little 3D look object. We have one star, we delete this. We don't need these lines which are forming here. Just delete these unwanted edges which is formed by default while you are doing some. Okay, here we got one small piece. We will change this into blue, and here we go, we got it. So it has become very easier when you have already decided which color to choose and when to use it. So we have used this palette to form this beautiful colorful icon which you can which is our logo. So let's that applies now. Put some text here like CAMPHER camphor, and let's make this bold and the other half regular and scale this up. Keep it in the center. So you got this camphor logo. We're using this beautiful color palettes. Now let's create some reflections. So I just select this all. Whoa, we have missed our one step, which is glossiness. So let's finish this up. I think we haven't grouped this up, so let's group this object one, leaving this camphor. Control G to group it, and copy it and paste it in the front by clicking Control F and combine it. Now we'll take a circle and we'll just strike this part from here, like clicking this, or let's just move this a little bit up. Now select both the object and subtract it and apply some white color. White. So choose it from the color palette and make it white. And in the transparency option, change this to soft light. In the same way, we will duplicate one more time, Control F, and paste in the front and combine this. Make a circle, place it somewhere here, select the both object, subtract it, apply the same feature here. So here we got the glossy effect as well as the color gradient, which has formed this logo, a very valuable and catchy one. So we have almost finished it, so let's create the reflection. So Control G, go to reflect tool, double click on it, you got this reflect palette, click horizontal, preview it and copy it. Now with the shift and control, just drag it down, arrow shift and arrow down key, drag it, just slide it down, make a rectangle and draw it over it. This will act as a mask object over it. So select both the object, go to transparency, make mask. Now you can select this one and apply the gradient here, like a grayscale. Let's apply some grayscale, and with the gradients tool selected, let's make it horizontal. Now in the gradient, we will make this little more opaque by reducing this. Okay, and once you got that, we will just adjust the gradient. We're using the gradient tool, see that its reflection is perfect, and if you're feeling it's okay, then fine. And there is one more thing we can add here to create a surface below the logo. We'll take a small rectangle, draw it over it, make it black, go to effect, blur, Gaussian blur, and blur it out. Click the preview option and see how much blur you have given. Increase the blurness and click OK. Now select the object, go to transparency, and in this you apply multiply and place this, keep it below the logo, and reduce this opacity to a little bit around 50, and you got the depth, and scale it this down a little bit more. It's very large, so scale it down, and you got the nice contact effect here. So this is how you can create a very simple and very effective and very beautiful logo using various very simple elements of the software, and here we got the output. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. Thank you very much.